In this video, we're going to be talking about voltage regulators. To understand what a voltage regulator is, we have to first understand the difference between an unregulated power supply and a regulated power supply. Let's first look at the unregulated power supply so you can understand what this word means. In a previous video, we actually designed an unregulated power supply. Let's recall what it does. You start with some AC voltage. In this example, we can imagine that we have 240 volts AC coming from the mains. We then have a transformer followed by a rectifier circuit. We might have a capacitor or some other elements in order to do some smoothing of the rectified signal. The main purpose overall of the power supply is to convert AC from the mains into a DC voltage that we can actually use in our circuits. The DC output of this circuit is unregulated. What it means is that it's not controlled. There are a few things that can affect it. The output of the unregulated power supply is going to be a fairly stable DC voltage, and by and large, it works very well. We can control the ripple by changing the value of this capacitor. On the other hand, there are several factors that can cause the DC voltage itself to change. First of all, if the load changes, then the DC voltage can also change. Typically, the smaller the load resistor, the lower the voltage is going to be. Furthermore, if the line voltage itself changes, then the voltage we get out of our power supply is also going to change. If we have 240 volts at the input, we might get a particular voltage at the output. But what if the line voltage drops by 10 volts? We're certainly not going to expect to get the same DC voltage at the output as we had when the AC voltage was 240 volts. The reason is that there's nothing in here to control the actual output voltage. We merely convert AC to DC, and furthermore, the temperature of our power supply is also going to change the DC voltage at the output a little bit. This happens because any change in temperature will result in a little bit of a change in the current that goes through the diodes. The diodes themselves, in other words, are a little bit temperature sensitive. What we're going to talk about in this video are two different types of voltage regulators. In other words, ways to potentially fix this problem. In this video, I'm going to just talk about the definition, and in the next video, we're going to actually design some of these regulators. What a voltage regulator does is it corrects all of these three problems in order to give you a stable DC voltage. In other words, a voltage regulator added after an unregulated power supply circuit will give you a predetermined designed DC voltage, which is independent of the load, independent of the line, and also independent of temperature. There are two different types of voltage regulators, a shunt regulator and a series regulator. Let's look at the shunt regulator first. The input to the shunt regulator is going to be the output of our unregulated power supply. It will be placed in shunt or parallel with our load resistor. The job of the shunt regulator is to reduce the voltage at the load when it's too high. A shunt regulator will not typically be able to increase the voltage at the load. This means that we need to overdesign our unregulated power supply. We need to make sure that the voltage is high enough such that we can lower it down with our regulator in order to provide a stable output voltage at our load. To show how this can be done, let's think about our unregulated power supply by a Thevenin equivalent circuit. We could think about our unregulated power supply as an imperfect DC source. That DC source will have a particular source impedance, R sub S. The more perfect the source, the smaller RS will be. But the presence of the RS basically means that when you start to draw more current from your power supply, you can expect the voltage to drop. If the voltage here at the output node is too high, the job of the regulator is to allow more current to pass through it in order to lower down the voltage. Let's say, for instance, that the current going through the load resistor is really small. The current through the load and the current through the regulator are all coming from our DC power supply. The voltage drop across this source impedance is directly related to the current that's flowing through it because of Ohm's law. This means that we can control the voltage just here at the right of the source resistor by varying the amount of current passing through it. We can change that current using the shunt regulator. So here's how it works. If you have a very small amount of current running through the load resistor, then the job of the regulator is to pass more current. On the other hand, if you have a lot of current flowing through the load resistor, then the regulator should not allow as much current to pass through itself. That creates a somewhat steady flow of current through R sub S and stabilizes the voltage at the output. In summary, a shunt regulator controls the current. Let's now look at a series regulator. How's it going to be different? The input to a series regulator is again the output of an unregulated power supply. A series regulator will then come between that power supply and our load. We can again replace our unregulated power supply with its Thevenin equivalent. Whereas a shunt regulator controls the current flowing through itself, a series regulator controls the voltage drop across itself. If the regulator senses that the voltage across the load resistor is too low, then it simply decreases its own voltage drop. If a series regulator senses that the voltage at the load resistor is too high, then it increases the voltage drop across itself to compensate. In summary, a series regulator controls its own voltage drop, whereas a shunt regulator controls its current flow. In the next two videos, we're going to learn how to design these regulators. We're going to start with a shunt regulator, then we'll move on to a series regulator, and then we'll move on to a more complicated regulator where we combine both elements in order to make a rock-solid stable DC output.